guys, welcome to the fishing adventure of Northern Hardcore Fisherman. Today, I'm going to show you how I make my own grip sinkle by just some simple construction using a little bit of this steel wire, very soft steel wire, just a normal kind of steel wire. To construct something that which is very very useful during the surf casting. So just a normal sinker that we normally use. This is the one that I made. What you can see that if you're using this kind of sinker, every time when you cast out you see to the spot where you want, it's important for you to you aim for this spot and you think that this is a very potential spot that will land you some kind of species. The strong current coming from this way. From this direction to this direction. Right? So when a strong current coming in this way, it tends to push your sinker slowly but surely to here. See your lines can pull all the way, tension is high, and sometimes you can't tell whether it's pulled by the fish or something like that, or it might start in somewhere or what. Like for example, if let's say there is something here, which as you know, there's some structure here, which might snag your sinker. You don't want to cast them, but the current might push it over there. And your line might get snagged over here. But your line might sunk there. So this is something that we don't want. That's why I make this kind of grip sinkle, a DIY. Very simple. Even a strong current going in this direction. Once you cast over there, once you sink down, when you pull your line, reeling your line. This the leg here to drink the sand and sink inside and pull your sinker there. Sometimes you might get like this. After you pull already in my sand like this. And for this part here, you stay inside the sand and you grip very firm and you stay there. So when a current is strong, they hardly push your sinker away. So this is very effective that your bait will stay somewhere now here. And sometimes that if you're using a long line, long fish line, your sinker stay here. Your hook line, let's say for example you attach it here, you have a long hook line, the current might push your line away from the sinker, and this will reduce the suspicion of the fish that they will not see the sinker or whatever, then they'll just grab your bait. So this is very useful. Even during the super strong high current timing, eventually that this thing might get push a little bit here and there, but as you can see that there is a four steel leg here. Until that it reach the point that a softer sand or something like that, the whole thing sink in, it will be very very difficult to push it over. It's very useful. So today I'm going to show you how I make this DIY grip sinker using a normal sinker. This one is cost about $1. So you plus the cost, the total cost of this thing, I think it's just less than $1. So you just it's a very simple construction. I'll show you how to make it. So first of all, you need some steel wire. You don't have to very very thick. Just a flexible kind. looking for a chip, a roll like this is something like $2, $3 a month. And then you might get some, you might need a plier, a Scotch Tape if you're doing it at home, and a zipper, and you'll need some fishing line, like just a normal fishing line will do. Like something that you're not using it anymore, use it to hire your distance drinker. So, okay, let's get started. You need some measurement on the length of the wire. First step is that you push your wire all the way to the eye, and you just roughly get the measurement. Get a measurement. Let's say that because we're going to curve it somewhere around in the front section here, so which is over here. We don't tie our line all the way through here because the line might slip off. We tie on this the flat surface here. So then this one now, this part here, we're going to bend it, curve it up. So it depends on what you like. You might sometimes you might prefer it to be shorter or longer. It's up to you if you like it. So this is our point around this length. Okay. And grab this thing firm. Curve it down. The other side. The tip of your finger, drop it down. So at this point here, you might use your Scotch Tape. A little bit of Scotch Tape. Get it around here. Stop the strip. Hold it firmly. Flip it to the other side. Now, so when you get the length that you want, see the wire here. Wire. You might want Thicken a little bit. Put it out a little bit, the steel wire. Before you start securing them. Right. So once you're done, then you get your line. Fishing line. So for the first step we're going to do, we let our line go through underneath any of the school legs. And just tie a simple hand knot for one. Second there. So once you're done, for the first round, you don't have to be pull it very tight. You go underneath the leg. Put it down like that. To the second leg, go underneath, go down, to the third one, go down, okay. Okay. Now when it comes to the first one, something that you need to note that you do the same step but going underneath the two legs, the first leg. But this time around, you wrap this second end here, wrap it in. So right now, we have done the first round. Now we can start just a little bit of force. Make sure that it's tight. Put it down like that. And when it comes to the first one with the second hand, wrap leg together with the second hand. Put it down, roll all the way up to this part here, or it's up, entirely up to you. If you want to, I mean, just a few rounds, something like that, it can be done as well. Up to you. So in this case, that's our roll up to half of the body. And then I expect that if you're in a rush and you needed one quickly, few rounds, couple of rounds, like 5 or 6 rounds, you will do the job, right? So when you are done, and you think that it's good enough, just move on the line. Okay. So this the thick end that you're coiling over the line here, you do another, overhand. Play a half inch, something like that. This time you go the other way around. Right. Let's put it down. The fire, which is a little bit now, this is the first check end that you have. Now you go over. First check end. Go underneath. The line that come up from the winding. So the opposite one. Right? The opposite one. And this time, this is the last one that we are going to lock it. So in four. Two times. So there you have it. Let's put it in a bit. And just use your hand to bend it down to the shape that you want. That I spent a little bit of time that I do in the more winding, more secure, a quick one. Right. Yeah, so basically these are the things that I have made, a bit simple, and I also made a some feel different kind of rip simple. For this one, the leg is about the same length as the pistol length. This one is this way. You can bend the steel wire according to your liking, something like that. Or this kind of long piece of sinker. There is also a short one. Bend it this way. You can even bend it all the way down as well. Right. And that. And you can do it onto a small sinker for tomorrow. All this can be kept easily inside your picker box. Just bring this thing back. bigger lake, maybe you want to try to get it this way. Here you have it. Oh, you are good to go. Ready for fishing. Well, I hope that this tip will help you on your next fishing trip. So if there are any questions regarding this sprinkler or something else, drop me a line on the comment box. And please subscribe to my channel. And thanks for watching. See you.